of the hill across the tracks. Only cool place in town.
Thank you. To see Mr. Devlin.
Oh, yeah, inside.
Well, that's him. I know it ain't proper, but in a town this size, I mean, until they're claimed, this is about the best we can do.
When?
Last night. Sometime just after dark, must have been.
How?
I don't know. All of a sudden, Bluey lit up half the county, busted windows for as far as a half mile away. Wasn't nothing left to do, just let the car burn itself out. It's out front there if you want to see it.
I mean, it was awful.
I only seen him once, yesterday, over at the hotel. You wouldn't even know it is him now.
Couldn't you do something for him?
Well, the county don't do alterations. Just box them and plant them. No frills, no organ music. Besides, what could anybody do for that?
That? That's got a name. Devlin. Whitey Devlin.
Thank you.
Next train to New Orleans.
Oh, I'm sorry. I couldn't hear you. Hearing aids built on here. See, I just can't hear without my glasses.
The next train to New Orleans?
Tomorrow? Same time as the one you came in on.
Bus?
We don't have no bus to New Orleans.
How about a cab?
Well, mister, the two we have would never make it.
Monsieur, you are no doubt on your way to the Mardi Gras, eh?
Yeah.
It is a wonderful, wonderful time of the year. It is a time of the year when you let all of your sins go out of your conscience and your heart gets pure. But then you go crazy singing, dancing, and utter exhaustion. I get tired just thinking about it. Oh, but monsieur, pardon, you must be thirsty. After the road, shall we give our guest a drink of wine, eh? You know, monsieur, we Cajuns, I guess, are the only ones who know the true meaning of the Mardi Gras. Oh, way back with my ancestors in France. People came from all over.
Monsieur, monsieur, return to your home immediately. Your wife is ill from worry. She has no tears left. Your children cry from hunger.
Celine!
Shh. Monsieur, listen to me and you will be forever grateful. Your poor wife.
I'm not married.
Please, monsieur, never lie. The children will be born dead.
I'm sure this child is foolish. She has many, many superstitions. I don't know where she gets them, but she's got them.
You will beg before I read the tarot card through you again.
No, Sherry. She does have a little gift with the cards.
Monsieur, I fear that you are left-handed.
No.
Aha! Very good. Because if you are left-handed, then you owe the devil one day's work.
Somebody else a day's work.
You have wax in your ear. No, it's good. It's there to soothe the brain. But if you think too much, it will melt the wax and you will become a madman.
Well, now, monsieur, you see what I have to put up with. Like so many of my people, the child is very primitive. But men like ourselves, men of the world, experienced. That is why I always pick up hitchhikers, always. Oh, you would be surprised if you knew the topics we discuss. Oh, la la.
What's the matter?
Look. The tree, a raven. You must not go on before it flies away.
Oh, what? We got to sit here till the bird makes up his mind?
May we, of course. It is an omen, but do not be afraid. We saw it just in time.
I'll go blind and all my teeth will fall out. Let's go.
You're old not to be married. My cousin Mathilde had two children by the time she was 16. My name is Celine. And this is my uncle Picot. Him. across the street. It's covered, son. This is what has been left in.
Ah, monsieur, but this is where we have to turn off.
Oh, wait.
Which way to Broussard Hotel?
It is just down the street, a little way. You turn and then go to the right. Forgive me. You know, monsieur, you are very fortunate to have a place to sleep at the Mardi Gras. Well, that is if you are stupid enough to want to waste your time sleeping.
Right. Wait, monsieur.
I'm going to need the bag, huh?
Monsieur, wait. This is his house.
Give him his bag. Come, we have to go.
Well, thanks, Uncle.
All right. Good luck.
Good luck, kid.
A lot of right-handed babies with wax in their hair.
Yeah.
7 times. 7 times, and each time the same. Monsieur? The hanged man.
Surely will. Yes, ma'am. Yes. I'm sorry, sir, but unless you have a reservation.
Which room is Honey Seeker?
Well, I'm sorry, sir, but we've been expressly instructed not to give out that information. If you have some business to conduct with Mr. Seeker, I suggest that you use the phone in the alcove.
Yeah, well, I got something to deliver to him.
Well, we'll see that he gets it.
Oh.
Well, if you feel the need of a receipt, we.
No. Sorry. He wants it right away, though.
Yes, yes.
I'm sorry, folks. We'll help you. We might try another hotel, but I know they won't have anything either. It's Mardi Gras, you know.
Give me any ideas for this one. Excuse me. Excuse me, sir. Pardon me, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Mr. Seeker's apartment, 307.
Right away, sir.
Excuse me. Sweetheart, keep your eyes on me, will you?
Sure.
Three, please.
Three.
Bellboy, package for Mr. Seeger.
It's a surprise.
Harry.
Where's Seeger?
He's on his way back from Seattle. What is it?
What are you doing here? Where's Whitey?
What are you doing here? Alive. He's dead!
Oh, no. What happened?
You tell me. You tell me what happened. I got questions, Mrs. Seeger. A lot of questions.
If you please, Mr. Seeger, this way.
Sorry, no close-ups. I haven't had time to shave.
Would you label your trip to Seattle a success, Mr. Seeger?
They'll be back on the job tomorrow. Would you call that a success?
Seeger, since you no longer have an official status with the union...
Still have my card. Lifetime membership. That nobody takes away.
Isn't it highly irregular that you could take upon yourself to fly out to the coast uninvited to address the strike?
Irregular? Maybe, yes, but it's a cinch they weren't listening to anyone else.
These wildcat strikes that have been erupting, there are rumors to the effect that they're secretly instigated by...
Rumors? You said rumors in there.
Yes, sir, but it's common not...
Question about facts.
How do you explain these strikes? Something must have prompted them.
You bet your sweet life something has. The incorruptible voice of the rank and file, 137,000 strong, crying out in protest. They haven't forgotten what Arnie Seeger has done for them.
Would you care to comment on Senator Jurgensen's speech, accusing you of misappropriation of union funds?
Yes, I would. I'd like to comment very much. But the FCC would take away your license. You know, it really gets me. The way a bunch of politicians can sit up there on Capitol Hill, hiding behind congressional immunity, and take potshots at a lot of decent, law-abiding citizens. Misappropriations? I've heard that my entire career off and on. You remember what the Hitler tactic was. Invent the big lie, then keep repeating it over and over until otherwise decent people begin saying, where there's smoke, there's fire. The big lie in a democracy? I hope not. I pray every night that we never come to that.
Mr. Seeger,
sorry, I'm late for an appointment with a lady, my wife.
Or do you have any comment on the death of your former business manager, Whitey Devlin?
I am deeply shocked.
You know I never loved Whitey. Whitey knew it too, but it didn't matter to him. I had to get away. That check, that was our plan. A canceled check for $50,000. It was worth five times that much to us. Arnie was stealing union funds. I found that check and gave it to Whitey.
Whitey was going to blackmail Arnie Seeger? What kind of garbage are you handing me, lady?
Can't you understand? Arnie won't let go. Look at me, Harry. Look at me. I used to think he was a giant. Maybe he once was. But I've been married to him for 6 years, and I'm in his prison. I can't get out.
They killed Whitey Devlin for a piece of paper.
This piece of paper can put him in prison for a long time.
Well, I'm going to save everybody a lot of trouble.
Is that what you really want? There's a way. Arnie can get money. He'll pay for this check.
Yeah.
Whitey didn't want Arnie dead. And do you think he wanted you executed for murder? His best friend. You were, you know. I don't know how many times he told me. Harry, the money can all be yours. I only need enough to get away. Help me.
Yeah, Miss Seeger, I'll help you. One way or another.
Thank you. Let's talk, Mr. Pace. Now.
Yeah?
It's going to work, Whitey.
I'm government, Harry.
Oh, yeah, really? Something wrong with my income tax?
Not that I know of. I could have it checked if you
like. Look, Mr.
Grip is the name. Just plain Grip, huh? I'll have a Sazerac. Local specialty. Try it. Bourbon.
The girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes it, when she passes, goes ah. When she walks, she's like a samba that swings so cool and sways so gently, that when she passes it, when she passes, goes ah. But he watched her so sadly. How can he tell her he loves her? Yes, he would give his heart gladly. But each day when she walks to the sea, she looks straight ahead, not at him. And then young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, he smiles, but she doesn't see.
I don't suppose you have it on you. You picked up something in the depot at Jason City.
Jason City?
I saw you.
So what are you asking for?
The government pays me to ask. And do you really think you can accomplish what Whitey Devlin couldn't?
Look, we're just playing grab, whatever it is. I don't know what you're talking about.
Damn it, Pace, you've got something, and I want to find out what it is. Now, I've invested 6 years of my life in this project. For 6 years, we've been building the government's case against Seeger. We broke his hold on the union by forcing an open election. Now, it's just a matter of time. Seeger is finished. We're going to get him to prison sooner or later. You could make it sooner, Pace.
Yeah, that'll be neat. On my grave, you can put my good citizen award.
I thought Whitey Devlin was a friend of yours.
I do it your way, and that's going to help Whitey.
Who, your way?
Well, let's just say it ain't going to make him any deader.
We can help find his killer, Harry.
Pace, Mr. Pace.
You know, you're in way over your head. Now, Arnie Seeger will step on you like a bug. I could have you taken into protective custody.
Look, I know you guys don't make too much money, so...
true. Last year, I had six relatives sleeping in my bedroom. I ended up in the bathtub. You ever sleep in a bathtub? And this year, it's worse.
You're welcome.
It's wonderful work that you do.
Good
me around your idea of a big evening?
Oh, I do not mind, monsieur.
Hmm. you weren't just a kid, I'd say you had one fight too many. You still got your crazy cards on you?
No, monsieur, they're not crazy.
Oh?
Oh, good. I'll flip through them a couple of times and see if they'll tell you where I can find me a room.
A room? You wish a room, monsieur?
Yeah, it'd be nice.
But, monsieur, I can show you a wonderful room. You'll love it just as I do. Come. Is it not a wonderful room?
Yeah, it is not a wonderful room, Mrs. Stable.
You do not like it?
Oh, I like it. I like it. It's quiet, clean, and comfy.
I can never understand the things you say.
You don't understand what I say.
Monsieur, why are you angry with me?
I'm not angry. I'm just tired and sleepy, that's all. You really stay here, huh?
Of course.
And Uncle Picot?
Naturally.
Naturally. Anybody else?
Oh, Robert, Gaston, Henri, and Martin.
Oh, but that's all. Huh?
Oh, now, tomorrow, Monsieur Devry arrives with his family.
Let's forget about tomorrow. Celine, take this. And I thank you, and have yourself a ball.
I do not want a ball.
No, honey, I mean, buy something, spend it, and have some fun, I mean. Okay?
It is very comfortable here on the floor. Over there.
You join the singing and dance for us.
Uncle, we have a guest.
Oh, where?
Over here, Uncle.
Huh? Oh. The hanged man.
I hope you don't mind.
No, 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 never, never. Have a drink and join the party.
No, I'll take a rain check. I'm kind of beat.
Yeah, I think tomorrow will be better. Tomorrow will be the best. All the families will gather and Good night. Sleep well.
What's that all about?
Oh, it will protect us from evil. No witch dare cross a broomstick.
He didn't exactly seem overjoyed to see me.
No, he was very pleased. Did he not invite you to the party?
Celine, what have you been following me around for?
To warn you that you are in very great danger.
Your tarot card? Something happened to me, you would be convinced that the cards were right, wouldn't you?
Of course.
Even though you were wrong about my being married and left-handed and all that.
But, monsieur, that was me. I am sometimes wrong. But the cards, they never lie.
Never?
Never. Well, perhaps once. Maybe twice. But then it was I who read them wrong. And I could not read them wrong 7 times, monsieur. 7 times.
Well, good night, kid.
Monsieur?
Yeah?
Monsieur, why do you carry a gun? Are you a criminal?
No. It's nothing like that. Why don't you ask your cards?
Do you remember in the car when I told you about my cousin Mathilde, who at 16 was married and had 2 children?
Yeah.
I am 16.
Whitey's dead and his crumbum friend has the check.
I told you he'd be back today.
You guarantee he'll be back? Suppose he gets hit by a car. Suppose they find him in the street somewhere with a certain piece of paper lying in his pocket. You want to sell raffle tickets to that one?
How can you be so sure he has it?
Are you kidding? Somebody's got it and it's a cinch it isn't me. You think Pace turned up here today to hold a wake for Whitey? Now there's nothing. This little zero, Harry Pace. Sure, everybody, line up. Take a bite out of Arnie Seeger.
You'll be able to handle Harry.
You better hope so, baby. Because if he don't turn up here today, these little trinkets of yours, you know, could melt like ice. Handle him. I'll make him wish he'd never heard my name.
Here, wait a minute. I'll move it for you. Have you got any coffee back there, Harry?
You did not sleep well last night. That was on your hands all night. Those who sleep like that have the devil on their back.
Tonight's a big night, huh?
Yes. Maybe we will win a prize.
Yeah.
Uncle Picot would be very pleased if you would ride with us.
And I got some business to take care of tonight, kid.
Oh, but everybody would be at the parade and no one would work on the night.
All right. What'd you do with it?
Do with what?
The gun.
You must not take it with you. You're in very grave danger.
Oh, come on, Celine.
Yeah, there is death in your card.
Honey, I know you're trying to help, but this doesn't exactly even out the odds. Now, please find it for me.
No. No, I do not give it to you. If I don't give it to you, then you will not go.
Yeah, wait a minute. Hold it. Hold it. Look, I haven't got time to play button-button with you. Get it for me.
Here, take it and go. Die, see if Celine cares.
Ready? Now, let's go get some of that coffee. Inside.
You pay much attention to time, monsieur. Hmm. Well, I planned for us a wonderful day. First, we go to the French market. Oh, and then you must.
No, kid, I'm here on business.
You're going to see a lady.
Ma'am.
But I am right that you do not like him. He worries you. What is his name?
Celine,
I will get rid of you.
Your what?
I will give a rooster a spoonful of whiskey. And I will take a slip of paper upon which is written the name of the person and slip it in his beak. Then I turn the rooster loose in a cemetery. Within 3 days, the person will be dead.
Oh. You go to school?
Sometimes.
Well, what about folks? Mother, father, that.
Oh, but I have many brothers and sisters. I am the only one among them who will never marry.
How come?
Look.
Very nice. I see you've got a foot with five toes, so what?
No, no, monsieur, look. See here, see? I cannot marry because there is yellow on it.
Oh, yeah. A little dirt, too. Of course, I suppose you could take a bath.
The yellow will never come off, monsieur. If you want to know, I take a bath every week.
Whether you need it or not?
Oh, monsieur.
Well, that's... fine.
No one should leave New Orleans before seeing the French Quarter.
Honey, do I have to spell it out for you? I'm sorry, kid, but that's it.
Edgy, Mr. Pace? You didn't sleep well?
Like a baby.
I'd hoped that our little talk would make a hard pillow.
This is Mr. Grepp. He's a very big man from Washington. This is Celine. She'll tell your fortune for you.
Have you told his? I could tell it. It's very clear to me.
Yeah, well, the answer is still no.
He's going to try something he's never even dreamed about. The only trouble is he doesn't know how, and it scares him. So he'll stall as long as possible, looking at his watch. It's a hard bounce from the third floor, Harry.
Have fun, kid.
You've got no style, Pete. No style.
No gun, either.
This him?
Yeah. And he's late.
Lois.
Arnie gets mad when anybody keeps him late.
Yeah. I'm all broken up.
Yeah. You may be.
Not my taste. Pick it up.
I didn't pick it up.
Flower pot in the hall.
Anything else in the flower pot?
No.
Give it back to him now. Outside. Drink, Gopher.
Lois, why don't you get some sunshine? We may be a while. She told me everything. But why the gun, Gopher?
One time loud and clear, Mr. Seeger. Don't ever call me that Gopher. Never.
Okay, Harry. Harry's all right, isn't it? Why the gun, Harry?
I was gonna blow your brains out.
Was? I'm relieved.
Whitey's dead and you're gonna pay for it. One way or the other.
I didn't kill Whitey.
No, you never do anything, do you? You're always in Chicago or somewhere. And the truck goes over the cliff. In L.A. at a party when there's an accident on a Jersey dock. Just shut up, Arnie. Shut up about the stuff you don't do.
What have you got, Gopher? What have you got?
A little louder.
Don't press your luck.
A canceled check on a Swiss bank. $50,000, your signature, made out to the brother-in-law of the Secretary of the Department of Garbage. Check number is 18533.
You sure you wouldn't rather use a gun? At least it'd be an honest stick-up.
Hey, Lois. Come on in here.
I want you to learn about high finance. In his corner, wearing a $50 suit and fighting out of his class is the Gopher. Look at his hands, honey. They're sweaty. That's always the tip-off. The little man, trying for the big score.
That's it, all right. Five times the face value of the check. Arnie, baby. $250,000.
You're not only out of your class, you're out of your head.
That may be. But I ran across a fellow named Greb.
Where can I reach you?
I'll call you.
When do I get the check?
When I get the money. Now, don't look so glum about it, honey. You'll do the same thing you always do.
Let's dip into those old union funds. Goodbye, Mrs. Sager.
You mean it? You'll really pay?
Sold, Mr. Cofer.
I want you to take this up to Mrs. Arnie Seeger. Mrs. Seeger. You got me?
Yes, sir. All
right.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Your fan club. You know, it seems I buried you too soon.
Maybe.
I keep hoping you'll wise up, Harry.
Yeah, well, think positive. Come on, kid. I'll buy you a costume for tonight.
Excuse me. May I help you? No, thank you. I'm just looking out. Shirley.
Well, I'll tell you what. Let's see how she looks in that dress and everything that goes with it, like, I don't know, shoes.
Oh, they're all right. Uh-huh. Shall we try it on? Right over there. Furiously all over town.
When?
In a few hours. He's frightened. Almost too frightened.
Well, we're just getting warmed up.
Please be careful.
You know, I know outdoor cafe, the Regis.
Yes.
Will you be there? 10 o'clock. You know, we'll wear a costume. We just melt in the crowd.
Thank you.
goodness. Don't you look pretty?
I knew you were meeting a lady. But you lied. Probably you lied about everything, and I am right about your having a wife and lots of children and your being left-handed.
Ma'am, I'll take this one here. Yeah, the one we looked at, and you just wrap it up, and I'll take them on with me, and that one she's got on, too.
Oh, all right.
Listen, kid, let me give you a little tip about what's true and what isn't. Because, you know, you're going to be growing up any day now. What happens then? Some kid, nice fella, comes along. And you're going to start with that broomsticks and chickens in the graveyard and those stupid cards. And he's going to say to himself, boy, what a nitwit. Because it doesn't happen that way, sweetheart. There isn't any magic anywhere. Nowhere. Your Mardi Gras comes along once a year, a couple of days, a whoopee, magic time, it's beautiful. And the party's over. You gotta come out from behind that make-believe wherever you are and see the way it really is with people. Everybody scratching just to stay alive.
You ought to count all the misplaced husbands.
Never trust your dream when you're about to fall in love. Or your dream will quickly fall apart.
Stop bothering the lady.
Oh, darling, I'm glad you're here.
Just a southern hospitality.
Oh, get lost. Friend of yours?
Well, you know how it is at the Mardi Gras.
No. How is it at the Mardi Gras? Look, this I don't need.
I'd like you to meet my husband.
Goodbye, husband.
Probably wait till you just so he can hide behind a mask and make passes. Oh, honey. Scotch straight, huh?
Enjoying yourself, Mr. Seeger? Mrs. Seeger? Do you mind?
Another fly, honey. This one's a government fly. He's got a wife, three kids, and a big mortgage. When he retires, he'll probably get a pat on the head and a letter from the president.
You gonna pay, honey?
For the drink? Sure.
You know what I mean.
He thinks I'm smarter than I am.
How many times have I told you? I'm just an ordinary union man.
With the exception of a little difference in take-home pay. You're going to lose, Arnie. I just talked to Pace.
Pace? That name rings a bell. Joe Pace? Eddie Pace?
Harry Pace.
That's a funny name.
What's he got on you, Arnie? A photograph? A tape? A letter? A check?
A letter from the gas company. I haven't paid my bill.
Whatever it is, he's going to pull it off.
Greb, you got the greatest one-track mind in the world.
Thanks.
Of course, the track's slow.
Well, let's say this works. Pace gets the money. You get whatever it is that he has. Let's say he even manages to get out of the country.
Hadn't we better be leaving?
So there's Harry Pace on the sunny sands of Rio. Now, for a month, it's a dream. Pretty girls, fine clothes, the best food. 2 months pass. Three, maybe a year. He begins to feel guilty. Whitey should be enjoying some of this. But poor Whitey's dead.
Can I try? I mean, I'd like to take a crack at this story, too.
All right.
Well, now, let's see. Harry's feeling guilty, like you said, maybe crying himself to sleep nights. Anyway, he reads the papers. Uncle Sugar's still trying to build a case against Arnie Seeger. But Seeger's still on his feet and free. You like this, Greg?
So far, perfect.
So finally, Harry's just got to stop crying and get some sleep. So what do you get in your mail one morning? An envelope with no return address. And what's inside?
A photostat.
Right, a photostat of my gas bill. He's just paid my gas bill.
Pleasure, Mrs. Seeger.
What a dull crap.
So if you're smart, really smart, I'll adjust your heart.
Anywhere in the world. When and where, Harry?
9:30 at Fountain Arch.
9:30 Fountain Arch. My man will be there.
Hold it. Hold it. Well, that's Seeger remote control. You be there. You can't press it.
Look, suppose your friend Greb nails me.
Well, Arnie, I guess that's just a chance you're going to have to take.
All right, Harry. You're calling the shots. Harry, you do have that check.
9:30, Arnie.
Are you or are you not going to pay him?
Go ahead, look it over.
ceased to amaze me, Harney.
Don't you think my life's worth a quarter of a million?
Of course. Well.
Well, what?
Well, if you're going, you better get going. You'll never get a cab in these crowds.
I got time. Who knows? I may not go out at all.
Now watch out. Who is it?
Alf.
He got away.
Alf!
Beautiful. Hurt bad.
You idiots.
Arnie, what is it?
The little man's got to make the big score after all.
You know, someday I am going to build a real big float. Biggest they have ever seen. Of course, we will have to have a tractor to pull it. That is because my old friend, you and I are getting old, eh? Don't worry, I will put you out to pasture. Hey, Celine. Celine.
Well, Celine, come on, hurry up. You want to miss the biggest parade of all?
Ah, you look so nice. Celine, you are a most beautiful, beautiful child.
No. Soon I will be a woman.
Oh. Sweet.
Very bad.
I'm not a doctor. Goldie. Easy, easy. Over.
Very kind, Xavier. Thank you very much. You are very, very brave. Oh, la la. If that was me, they would have heard me scream in Baton Rouge.
Perhaps if you were to leave, you would get some sleep, huh? Tired.
Yeah, of course. What do you think this is, a circus, eh? All right, get out, all of you. We will meet later at the Mardi Gras parade, eh? Avant.
Soon you will get well. See, you're a very lucky man. Let's get some sleep, huh?
Well, please don't. Put it back.
I wish to make you more comfortable.
Let me have it.
Please,
see that crummy old piece of paper? It's my ticket.
The moon. Seeger's gonna wish that I had killed him. I'll bleed him to death. Put it back in my shoe, please. Ah.
like a bloody king. Go to places I never even dreamed of.
Say, you remember in the costume shop when you spoke to me about my magic world? My land of make-believe. Well, now, monsieur, you talk of going to the moon, living like a king, seeing places you've never even heard the name of.
No, I... Oh, no, monsieur, please, you must not try to get up. Remember, Xavier, you have said you have lost so much blood you could die. No, oh, please, I cannot let you... monsieur!
Harry. Errands. Harry Pace is great for running errands.
Why? Is this you?
It's me.
What?
All right, boy. Where's the check?
I saw you in the ice house.
I want that check, Harry.
We're going to get the money.
Harry's going to get the money. Just the way he was supposed to.
All you saw in the ice house?
No bum.
You didn't doubt for a minute it was me, did you? Neither did anyone else. Come on, little girl. Smile. Wave at the nice people.
That's it.
Somebody had to do it. Arnie had never let me get away. I would have spent the rest of my life looking over my shoulder. Now, I couldn't do that, could I? Ah, this way is perfect. You get the money, I take it from you. Arnie never knows the difference. He's not going to look for me. I'm dead already.
I would have killed Seeger for you, Arnie.
It's a good thing you didn't, Harry. A dead Arnie Seeger is not worth a dime.
Trying to pull this time. Listen, let me tell you something about the law.
Oh, Whitey. Whitey.
6 years. 6 years.
I see many things happening to you. You are going to be very busy. You are going to take a long trip.
Celine! Celine!
Oh. Well, I must go.
Thanks for everything. Good luck in her cards from now on, huh?
Yeah, if you believe in that kind of stuff.
Au revoir, Monsieur Pace! Au revoir, Gaylord! Au revoir!
Gaylord, what's that?
That's my name.
Gaylord?
All right, forget it, Harry. Let's go.
Gaylord Graham.
Right.
Okay. That's interesting.
Next on Mystery, a private eye escapes the mob and heads to Hawaii, only to fall right into a puzzling murder case. Bruce Stern stars in Trenchcoat in Paradise.